This is WNEW-FM in New York. I have the extremely sad task of informing you that John Lennon died tonight. He was shot and fatally wounded in front of his home at the Dakota. This report has now been confirmed by all of the other wire services, and this is a New York City police report. At a loss for words. I think for the first time in my career on the radio, I don't have anything to say.
This is an NBC News hotline report. This is Ann Taylor. New York City police say that former Beatle John Lennon was shot and killed tonight in front of his home on Manhattan's Upper West Side. With a special report, NBC correspondent Brian Ross. Brian?
Police at the scene at Lennon's luxurious apartment house on the Upper West Side of New York say Lennon was shot fatally by an unknown assailant who opened fire at Lennon as he stepped out of a limousine on 72nd Street on the west side of New York. Lennon was accompanied by his wife, Yoko Ono, as he stepped out of the limousine. The assailant apparently was with the doorman at the apartment building and opened fire, firing, according to eyewitnesses, 4 or 5 shots. A woman at the scene says there was no discussion before the shot. The man began firing, and all she heard was the screams of Yoko Ono. A passing taxi cab driver rushed to the scene and said he saw Lennon on the ground with blood coming from his mouth and from his chest. The taxi driver said he believed that Lennon was shot in the back. Police at the scene say at this moment they have an assailant in custody, a white male whose identity has not been revealed. At this point, no motive is known for the shooting. Brian Ross, NBC News, New York.
This has been an NBC News hotline report. This is Ann Taylor.
And this is WNEW-FM in New York. And let it all be very sad news tonight of the murder of John Lennon. At 11 o'clock, he was shot in front of the Dakota as he and Yoko Ono were leaving their apartment, their place of residence. Was taken to Roosevelt Hospital. We have tons of information, all of it sketchy and different, and the one thing that remains the same in all of these reports is the very sad and very shocking conclusion of these reports that John Lennon is dead. Jack Douglas, Lennon's producer, said the singer and his wife had been at a studio at the record plant earlier tonight, and that Lennon left at 10:30. Said Lennon was going to get a bite to eat and go home. A gentleman who was identified as a pedestrian said at the hospital that he was walking south near 72nd Street when he heard 4 shots. Said he came around the corner to Central Park West and he saw John Lennon being put into the back of a police car. He was taken to Roosevelt Hospital. A man has been taken into custody. Evidently, this person who was taken into custody had been described by some as crouching in the archway of the Dakota as if he were waiting for Lennon to come. This person has been described as a pudgy kind of man by eyewitnesses, 35 to 40 years old, with brown hair. He was immediately put into another police car, taken into custody. An eyewitness said, quote, he had a smirk on his face, end quote. And as I say, there's so much more information. Evidently, now they're saying that he was pronounced dead shortly after arrival at Roosevelt Hospital. One of the earlier reports talked about the medical staff at Roosevelt working with great diligence and hurry in an attempt to save his life. He was shot in the chest at least 3 times. John Lennon, it's an amazing thing. It's not just another, I don't know how to say this without it sounding, you know, mundane or was not just another person in the public eye. You know, he was not just another star. He was not just another rock star or movie star or politician or whoever. John Lennon, the enormous amount of grief that is being expressed tonight by people, certainly picking up the telephone, listening to phone calls here at the station, is incredible. A man was somebody that who touched the hearts and minds of us all as a Beatle, still as a Beatle, and as John Lennon, as he fought so hard to gain his identity as John Lennon. And it's almost as if I'm just flashing back to the day that John Kennedy was shot and killed, and I feel a similar loss and a similar grief. You know, it's something that again goes above and beyond the public figure to somebody who we all dearly loved and who gave us so much, you know. And we gave it back to him too, you know. We loved him too. We loved him, and we let him know in a thousand different ways, and particularly here in New York, he was one of us. He has been a New Yorker for so many years now, and you'd see him walking on the streets and stuff, you know, and you'd wave and say, "Hi, John." And I've heard so many stories from cab drivers who picked him up and who refused to let him pay, you know, just because they said, "Hey, thank you for all that music. Thank you for all those years." And what a sad and terrible thing that he has to meet his end in this violent, damnable fashion. So if you believe in prayer, say a prayer for John Lennon, and say a prayer for Yoko Ono, and say a prayer for the rest of us. This is WNEW-FM in New York.